Hi, I'm Daphne Richards, and this is Augie. Our question this week is, do sotols die after blooming? Well, it's easy to confuse all of the various beautiful desert plants that are making their way into our central Texas landscapes these days. Yuccas, agaves, sotols, nolinas, and others all have similarities. And one of those similarities is a skyward shooting bloom stalk. One of those groups of desert plants, the agaves, do die after blooming. But other desert species, including deslerion, which are the sotols, they don't. All of these desert plants may take many weeks or even months to form their glorious bloom stalk, which start to emerge in early spring and may not be fully spent until late summer or early fall. Cutting out the bloom stalk after it's seen its better days can be challenging. You'll need some heavy-duty gloves to protect your hands from the sharply toothed margins of the sotol leaves. And you'll need a small handsaw, like you might use to cut small tree branches. It would be very challenging to get a pair of pruning shears down into the space where you'd need to make the cut, and you'd also be surprised at how hard and thick that bloom stalk may be. As with pruning tree limbs, I recommend you cut the top off first to remove the weight. Then you won't have to worry about the potential of cutting halfway through the bloom stalk and then it toppling over and causing damage. Our plant this week is oregano, of which there are many different types and varieties and cultivars. This kitchen herb is so easy to grow that you'll never need to purchase it in the produce section ever again. It makes a great ground cover, and in fact, without an intervention, oregano will creep steadily across any garden bed that you plant it in, much the same as many of its other minty relatives. Oregano spreads by rhizomes, and so it's very easy to dig up a hunk of it and transplant it to another area of your garden, or to give it to friends. Some cultivars get much taller than others, so be sure to get the right one for your space. Full sun's great, but a little shade is fine too. Oregano will do fine on once-a-week irrigation and performs best with a little organic matter in the soil. In warmer winters, it may remain evergreen, but will still need to be sheared back all the way to the ground to encourage new growth in early spring. Some cultivars flower easily, while others rarely do. But this plant is grown for its leaves, so you really don't want it to flower anyway. In your garden this week, be on the lookout for chinch bugs, webworms, and spider mites. We'd love to hear from you, so please visit us at klru.org/ctg to send us your questions and pictures from your garden.